believe that the world will be destroyed someday. They call it Ragnarok, the destiny of the gods. Asgard will be attacked by certain fire giants. A monstrous wolf will swallow the sun, and the gods will fight in vain against the gods. There is nothing they can do.
Tell me, Drew, how did you escape your darkness?
Senua, once I found my purpose, I was no longer enslaved to the suffering I had to endure to reach it. Unclouded by fear. Senua, if I can survive the fire of Surt and escape my darkness, then so can you.
I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. This darkness takes everything. Everyone.
Senua. Are you sure you want to do this? We can fight this together. Side by side. We always do.
This is my battle. I have to face it alone. Away from here.
Where will you go?
I don't know.
For how long?
I don't know.
I believe in you. You know that. Just promise me that you will come back to me. I want you to say it. I want you to say it.
I will come back to you. I promise.
Fall. Even the gods have their time. Yet we still go on. Why?
I made a promise. And I will go to hell to keep it.
I die free, knowing you will carry my stories with you. The next to fulfill yours.
Then I will see you in hell.
Be ready to face horror in the eye as I have, to find your answers, your quest.
Truth was a troubled man, scholar turned slave. They tortured him, took him with them on their raids, drove him to madness. Spreading this new form of darkness to new worlds, to my world, Fenua saw a deep connection form between the Northmen and the darkness. His tales of hell were true. Then that was the source of it. She learned everything she could from him. Until she too could see what he saw. Of self is shattered. You simply cease to be. Don't you not seem that way to others? You know when it is true. You can feel it. A stranger in your own body. An imposter. And nothing is the same ever again. Fenua has died. Funny. We all want to see behind the veil, don't we? Once we do, we mostly just close our eyes again and pretend what we saw was never really there. She tried. Begged. you. Because once you gaze into the relentless darkness, all that lurks within it can see you too.
Comes from ravens, allowing the ravens to break his magic seal.
Show me what you have seen, Truth. Look how much it's changed. The world that looks the same but feels different. An imposter world. The forest itself is watching. Another game.
Ravens.
Where are they?
Can't you see them? She can't see them.
Look around.
Look around.
Try to find the ravens.
Line up the ravens.
Line them up. He said to line them up.
Thank you. illusions. You can't always trust dreams.
Those who make it back are forever changed.
Was a frost giant, a being of darkness, and all his sons and grandsons were dark after him. Of his daughters and granddaughters, some were monstrous, but others fair. But there was another who came from the ice, Buri. In shape, he was like a man, big and powerful. His son, Bor, took a fair giant to be his wife, and they had three sons. Odin was the eldest, and the Northmen hold him to be the foremost of the gods, the All-Father.
Do you know what it's like to leave everything behind? Your home, loved ones, to head deep into the wilds, perhaps never to return. Senua does. Because when darkness speaks, it changes everything. Turning home into a foreign land and loved ones into strangers. Exile makes sense when you realize that you were never really home in the first place.
song. Valradin's song. It's over here. It's over here. He's there. It's over there. Look, it's here. There's two. Listen, focus. Listen. It's my plate. It's my plate. This reminds me of the forest. Which forest? How is going to run?
The wilds.
She left the wild. She went to the wilds a long time ago. Why did she go to the wild?
She wanted to fight her own darkness. She thought she could beat her own.
Did she beat her darkness?
No. It nearly killed her, but she tried.
Druth helped her.
If it wasn't for Druth, she'd be dead.
She can't beat her own darkness. She wanted to marry Dillian.
She came to beat her own darkness.
But she did what?
She thought her curse would spread to him.
She thought her curse would spread to him. She thought she'd bring the darkness to him too. She nearly died.
She thought the curse might have killed him.
Druth helped her.
The Northmen say that Odin and his brothers killed Ymir, and that the world of men was formed from his corpse. They made his bones into stone, and his flesh into earth, and his blood into the salt sea. They set his skull to be the bowl of the sky, with his brains for clouds. Odin and his brothers caught the sparks flying from Muspel and made them into stars. And to protect the new world from the giants, they used Ymir's great power.
The ravens.
They've gone.
No.
Half of them have gone.
They've gone. He's not helping.
It's true.
Quiet.
Out in the wilds. In the cold winter woods.
Where?
She no longer felt fit for this world. She almost gave in to the darkness. She remembered Dillian's words. She remembered her promise. She resolved to fight on and kill that which had become part of her. There is no such thing as victory when it comes to the darkness. It's like a good killer. Yet, for Nord, her biding its time. Only when she is at her weakest will it strike to kill. Will she find Dillian before her time comes?